Hello, friends. Welcome back to 7 Days to Die with your host, RongoTheBold. So, I have been thinking and planning and configuring and wondering and pondering, and this is going to be the last week of this playthrough. We are getting close. There's nothing much else to build. I have decoration tasks to do. I failed and did not reach out to Willow West and Finowin for my pass, so I'm going to do it without them because I was a slacker. And I have people staring at me, which is really annoying, but that's okay. That's okay. I can deal. Let's go ahead and get this upgraded. And so this will be, tonight will be our last Horde night for this series. Excitement. Day 77 Horde should be good. I spent last night, I got the spillways cut through, and thanks to Joe Park, he was pointing out the fact that I should take at least some physics into account. I've convinced him that it's a mystery spot. I don't know if you guys have ever been to one of those mystery spots out there in the world where, you know, gravity flows up, water flows uphill. So we're just going to assume that this is a weird gravitational anomaly and the water actually flows up to the lake from the frozen river over yon, over, where the hell is it? God, this place is so huge. This is by far the biggest thing I've ever built. So yeah, so the water flows up from this lake, up the frozen river, up the waterfall, into the lake up there, and then turns and flows through the dam, the turbines, out the spillway, and into the lake again. So it's a circle of life, you know? Circle of life. Just want to have a few things upgraded. I was going to put another platform down. Just to have a little bit more protection today. Oops. Because this has caught me out a few times, so I'm going to make these pillars themselves a wee bit thicker. And I brought a bunch of iron with me. Scrap. I know it's more efficient to do the scrap frames first, but I'm lazy. And they have a lot of wood. Probably as I ran out of wood. Oh. Doi. Alright, then we'll platform it up. How much wood do I have? 700. Okay, not a lot. Okay, there's a good platform. Oh, and I have a ramp for this one. I guess that's a detail, right? Just make it a little bit stronger by doing that. Okay. I may have to wrap. Yeah, I may have to knock a tree down. We'll see. So today I'm just going to work on the dam a little bit more. Kind of do an overview of where we're at. Oh, wow. I did not think I was going to run out of iron first. I had 4,000 iron on me. Man, you get the iron so quickly. So quickly. Do I have any? Oh, I got shingles. Shingles will work. We don't really care too much about it being amazeballs. Besides, when I upgrade them, this should become perfect. And the wood. Alright, let's go knock one tree down. One tree only, please. And thank you very much. Whee! I'm a lumberjack and I'm gonna get shot in the head. So, thank you for everyone for the suggestions on what to do kind of next while we wait for Alpha 16, which hopefully won't be that much longer. Whee! And I think that I'm going to do kind of a revisit of some older games that I had looked at. And then I think I'm also going to do a short playthrough of Rising World, which is another survival crafting game I played a little bit of. By no means an expert of it, or any other regarding it. But it's had a lot of updates recently. Still no real threat. There's some mobs, you know, some animals that'll kill you, but it's pretty otherwise easy to survive. I was just sitting there. I've been playing True Survivor mod, and I would love to have found some wonderful. Wonderful feathers there. This was a failed attempt at being amazing. So much extra work and for this whole thing. And it was, oh shit, I almost started to fall. That would have been bad. So much work I put into this, and I've never really... You know, we could do part of the horde up here tonight. I mean, we haven't done this in a long time, so maybe that'll work out. I will need to pick up some additional concrete just to repair that a bit. Okay, there we go. So let's go grab some additional concrete. What else did I get done? I got the buttresses on the front side of the dam done, and I've got the buttresses on the back side of the dam marked out. Started to put them up. So that needs to continue. Alright. I have some concrete buckets. I had 5 concrete buckets here. We're nearing the end of our concrete making, which is so sad. Only not. Ladders, windows, ramps. What we might do is work on the catwalk a little bit. Ah, oh, there we go. I needed more ice for the back 9. We can do some nightstands for the houses. No, focus, Rongo. Focus. I swear sometimes it feels like this thing fills itself up. Right about... Stop! Alright, who's got some concrete for me? You got sand. Oh, there we go. Always making... concrete. That's what this name of the series has been. ABC. Always be concreting. as Midnight would say. Alright, and what are you making? You're not doing jack or shit, so why don't you turn you off? I could use a little more scrap iron. Oh, here. Let me grab 10,000 scrap iron, and I'll grab a couple of these guys and just scrap them over here so they're ready to go. Scrap you. Anything else over here? You guys can go away. You guys can probably go away as well. And you can have my jars. And you can have my sand. It's a wonderful world. Well, I hope you guys have enjoyed this season. Like I mentioned a few times, next season is definitely not going to be a massive build. I have not really done much adventuring, not much exploring. I have, a few here and there. Let's go this way. We've got a few things like, this is tough. Does not do well on slopes. Ooh, what does this need? Forged iron. Yeah, let me grab that real fast, because that door is pretty freaking hammered. And I've got some forged iron right here. Thank you very much. I've had fun. It's been the biggest build I've ever done in the game. It's definitely been a little bit of a different game style. All right, there we go. All better. Who's got some owies? There we go. You're good. I hear Snowboy. Well, this needs wood to repair? You wouldn't have expected that. I wouldn't have expected that. Okay, I want to thank everybody who has stuck around this series. I know it's been, like I said, it's been different. There hasn't been the usual level of excitement and peril. After all, we are on day 77. I've died once and I've killed 2,300 zombies. So, I've been doing pretty well for myself this season. Even on survivalist settings. Alright, that looks... Looks good. Yep. You're all healthy. Oh, holy sh! I thought it said 54 iron. I'm like, whoa. Spendy much? Alright, so that fixes that up. Did I replace? I did replace that door. Wow, those got hammered hard. They should be able to dry before the horde tonight. Shift time. It should be okay. You want to mix it up? We've proven that the kill floor works marvelously. The only thing I was thinking of doing on the kill floor was putting in a little, like a passageway. Ooh, I got a free upgrade there. Putting in a little bit of a passage, tunnel, hallway, where I could funnel them in. I need to make ammo. I know I am out of ammo. Did I bring... Oh, hello, mister. Yep, I did. I do have ammo. Do I have ammo? Oh, shit. I have... Oh, you know what? We gotta do that tonight. We've got a nice rocket launcher. Let's assemble it. Grab its rockets out. So we've got 9 shots with the rocket launcher. Oh, we have more than 9 shots with the rocket launcher. Any other rockets? Red glare? I do need to get the, get a good AK ready to go. Just not a fan of the SMG. Just not a fan of it. But I've got a lot of ammo for it. So maybe I'll throw one together just to, you know, fire it off. Man, so much Magnum parts. Alright. So this one there. So we've got 13. Let me pull one out of this one. So we'll have a total of 14 shots with a rocket launcher. That'll really trash my place. Okay. Let's get rid of this guy. He's gonna be a pain in my ass. Alright, sweet. Okay, so let's go show one more quick little thing up here. I think we've got... I'm running low on food. I'm gonna have to do a harvest. In case you guys haven't seen the greenhouse lately. The greenhouse is very green. I have a lot of corn. A lot of aloe. It's been good. Where are my hops? Did I not replant hops? Ooh. You have the hovering in mid-air mushrooms, which seem to work just fine. Oh, we could do the, yeah. So I'll show you how I punched the spillway through. So we're going to need to make a switchback set of stairs that go all the way up to the top. So they'll come off right here. And me need to fix... Yeah, let's just do this. Concrete block. Let's just make, like, 50. Okay, so I was doing that. Now, we've got that catwalk, which needs to run all the way around this. So these are going to be my buttresses. I'll have a buttress here, a buttress there, and then a double buttress here in the middle. So that's my spillways have come through. So the one thing I've got to do is figure out just where... Oops. Falling down. Just where this will actually come out. One small stone just hanging out. One small stone for mankind. So I need more concrete to finish this part off. So this is about probably 10 blocks lower than it is on the front face of the dam. So that'll give us the drop we need. And then this is just our backside river. Backside river, that sounds bad. Or it's band name, one of the two. This is a lot bigger than the one on the other side, but it's also a shorter river. I do hope they do one more pass on water. I mean, Minecraft does better flowing water than this game does. Yeah, it works. I mean, the ice looks great. The ice texture, which is not used in the damn game, is amazing. They used to have the little ice patches in the snow biomes. Little snow lakes and stuff. I hope that Robert, the guy who's doing the development for the Random Gen, I hope he, you know, figures out a cool way where you could, for sub-biomes, that you could specify needs to be level, and it would level off an area, and then you could build lakes that way, if you had a level space. Lakes, or ponds, I should say. And you could have frozen ponds and golden ponds. And you could be on one. There we go. We're almost done with this build. I'm so excited. I may also do a short run on True Survivor mod. It's kicking my ass. Man, everything I thought about how I play the game doesn't work. I've been dying left and right, even on noob settings. Alright, this is just... a little turbulent action here at the before it hits the water. I thought I made this a little wider as well. I think I did. Okay. Good, 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 good. So the next episode's gonna be our horde fight. I'll spend the rest of this day working on the spillways, getting those put together. Probably need to go ahead and make another 100. Don't need that much more concrete, so I'm taking it easy. Sorry, I went quiet there. Thinking, planning. I did it again. Jam, you Rongo. Talk all the time. I don't wanna. Yeah. Yeah, after the first, you know, five or six of those, you really don't need anything. I like having those little pockets of water. There we go, the most amazing frozen river of all time. So yeah, all you gotta do is work on the outlets. It'll basically be just like a meow with a meow in the middle, and then the ice will spill out, or the water, quote unquote water, will spill out. So I will see you guys back here for the day 77 horde. If you are liking it, click that like button. Let me know in the comments below what you think. Tell your friends, your family, and your grandmamas, and I will see you all another day. Bye bye.